Krana Weep Mini Bong, and welcome back to my channel where we talk about all things Transformers and Transformers action figure related. And today on my channel, I'm coming back at you with some stuff and things that I've found from the four corners of the Tinterweb. I do this every single Tuesday and Saturday on my channel, so if you like the sound of that, why not think about giving me a like, a share, and a subscribe, because it really does help me out. Before we dip into the Transformers news, just time to check in with those cheeky chappies over at Ramin Toys, who are working on something that I am super hyped about. These are the 80s Commandos, known to you and I as the Centurions Power Extreme. So they've been rescaling the figures from what was originally a 7-inch figure, now down to about 6 inches. We can see how they're getting on here. These are just the prototypes, but the images in the background look amazing. Loving the paintwork on these, loving the progress, and I really like the way that they are keeping all of the fans and the people that want to support them really linked in on their Facebook. Again, these are Ramin Toys. If you like them as much as I do, go check them out over on Facebook. I'm super hyped. Can't wait for the pre-orders to go up.
And now the news. Don't touch that dial.
Kicking off with Funbee Studios, and I showed you just the tip last week of the Octopus, or the Cyber Octopus, that they are creating, and now we get to see the full thing in all its glory, and this looks incredible. It looks huge. It's actually part of a base system as well, which I guess is okay, and the back can come out and it can form part of a base for some of your Pretenders and Seacon type things, I guess. I wouldn't use it for that, but yeah, it looks okay. I need to get me a 3D printer ASAP. If you have any recommendations around good 3D printers, please let me know down in the comments, because I definitely want to pick one up. The team over at NACO Make have been showing off this insanely detailed version of Grimlock. To me, this looks like the happy marriage of a Bayverse Grimlock and a G1 Grimlock, with maybe a little bit of War for Cybertron stuff thrown up. I actually really like, and this is something that's come from the Bayverse, the fact that the dinosaur's head sits on the shoulder as almost like a piece of armor. I really like that, and I'd love to see that incorporated into more Grimlock figures going forward. This dude doesn't transform, but it's super, super detailed. Absolutely gorgeous. Loving it. Stuff over on Show Z now. So, AOI Mech, they are releasing a Nemesis Prime version of their KO version of the Siege version of Optimus Prime. I actually own their take on the normal Siege Prime, and it's really good. You know, I love it. It's got some die cast in it. It's much bigger than the original. So the Nemesis version here as well, if you haven't picked this up in any other way and you want to get yourself a big old Prime in this styling, well worth a pickup. I absolutely love mine. So yeah, get your hands on this dude as soon as possible. Really, really nice. Just needs a few stickers to make it up. Also, they're getting some pre-orders in for Mech Toys versions of Six Ninja, which to you and I is Six Shot. So yeah, this is not a new figure, but this is a pre-order up for a bit of a restock. Great looking figure, not a figure that I actually own. I do own quite a lot of the Mech Fans Toys stuff, but yeah, it's definitely something that I would think about picking up. Let me know your thoughts on this dude down in the comments. Is he worth a pickup? Let me know. Then moving on to something that's going to be a recolor, I guess. So APC Toys Angel Engine, which is their RC, but as it says here, this is going to be a pink version. I know this is black and white, this is the only picture I could find, but there's going to be a pink version of this coming, so that is actually pretty cool. Nice to know. I don't think it will force me to go and pick up this figure again, because although I love it in both modes, it was a little bit loose. I don't think I need a pink version. New figure dropping from Shong. This is the SS-01 Imperial Destruction, and this, to you and I, is a new take on Galvatron. This dude is going to be 12 centimeters tall. Hopefully this will look incredible. Just a picture right now. I will keep you updated as this goes. As we know, Magic Square are currently releasing their take on the Stunticons. We've seen a couple of the Stunticons so far, but now we can see the big boss himself, Motormaster, and this bot mode looks really, really nice. I think it looks very clean, very, very nice, not blocky at all. Magic Square stuff can look a little bit blocky sometimes. I guess Motormaster is quite blocky anyway, so it suits the styling. The alt mode, yeah, this does look a little bit more blocky, but I definitely like their take on the combiner itself. I think this actually looks really, really good. Something that I am definitely thinking about picking up now. I wasn't thinking about picking this up until I saw what the combined mode will look like. And yeah, I think I am going to get on this now, because I didn't pick up the X-Transbots trailer, and I would like to have a Menasaur in my collection, even at this scale. Staying with Magic Square, looks like they're going to be releasing a Perceptor. So we have the prototype here, and we also got to see the colored version here as well. Looks nice. I don't own any Perceptors. May have to dip into this as well. Moving over to the world of Vans Hobby. They are still releasing their Headmaster Juniors, and this is their Ace Hitter, or to you and I, this is Shutter. So nice, nice looking. The car here, the alt mode, is looking nicer and nicer the more I see it. Loving all the translucent blue all over this. Hopefully, well, I already know it's going to come with stickers, unfortunately, because this is the way that they do things over there. But overall, looks very, very nice. Those lights, I guess, will go up and down. Plenty of translucent coming. Very, very nice. Moving over to something I haven't seen before. This is something called Iron Warriors. This is the IW05 Pioneer. This is somebody's take on a Transformers Prime, Optimus Prime. Now, unfortunately, we don't get a clear view on any kind of alt mode for this, so I can't tell you if it transforms or not. But it definitely comes with accessories, a massive sword, and we can see that it actually has two heads. So the version of Prime's head that I hate with lips, no thank you, and the correct version, especially in 2021, of him with his face cover or his battle mask. Looks like it articulates nicely, looks nicely detailed as well. Now I'm really thinking about picking this dude up so I can compare it to my favorite take on the Transformers Prime, which is the APC version. So as soon as this gets released, I will definitely be picking this up in red, because I don't own a red Transformers Prime Optimus Prime at the moment. Legs look super detailed as well. Moving over to the world of New Age, and they are getting ready to ship their Shattered Glass take on Megatron. Very, very interesting. So this is part of their Legendary Heroes collection, part of the multiverse, and the Shattered Glass take on Megatron should be pretty nice. Hype for it. Hasbro have been showing off more of the Netflix versions of figures. So this is the Netflix release, the special version. So we get the Sparkless, and we also get the Ironhide, which is now the Quintesson Guard version of Ironhide. And then there's also the Cheetor with the gut cannon, from what I can see. And also Deep Cover. We got like a Deep Cover weeks ago, it feels like now. So these have been very quietly released, no fanfare whatsoever. In the States, people are already picking this up. I think Target's in the States. In the UK, these are available on the brand new Hasbro Pulse. We'll come to that in a bit. For me, there's nothing really for me here. I think if I wanted the deep cover, I'd get the Generation Selects one because I prefer the color on that one. Let me know your thoughts. Is there anything that you're super interested in here? I think it's a bit, you know, I think Hasbro just fallen asleep at the wheel here, right, for this one. Whole collection together, nah, not for me. Something that is interesting me, and finally get to see little glimpses, Galvatron. Is that you? Here's a hint. Here's my legs. Yes. Awesome. I can't wait. Super hyped to actually start to see pictures of this. I believe this was Kamzig Reviews who released this originally. But I'm super hyped to see anything for the Galvatron. Feels like I've been talking about Kingdom Galvatron on this channel now for over a year since it was teased on the Kingdom box to finally start to see the figure. Nice. Can't wait. Little bit of a blurry tease of a Kingdom Sideswipe here. Now, I think that this will probably take the same form as the Sunstreaker, right? But it does look a little bit like it's held together a little bit better. I'm super hyped for this. If it looks good, if it's all the same shade of red, no doubt we'll see more images of this coming soon. But yeah, I'm excited for this. Mystery box. So the next Netflix spoiler box is teased online by Hasbro, and it looks really cool. I love all of the green plant life all over it. It's definitely a Decepticon. 100% it's a Decepticon. Personally, I think I know what it is. So if you don't want to hear that, fast forward about 20 to 30 seconds and you won't hear it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I think that this is the Megatron. So this is a Beast Wars Megatron with the Crystal Paleotrex. That's what I think is inside it. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Beast Wars figures are getting re-released, and we got to see Barney in his box this time. So really, really cool looking boxes. And also Rat Trap is going to be on the blister card. So yeah, boxes look nice. Not things that I'm too excited about picking up really. But yeah, very, very cool looking artwork. Hasbro Fan Fest is coming back to us. Last year was pretty cool, and this year, because I'm in the UK, I'm going to be able to enjoy all of the benefits of Hasbro Fan Fest because we now have the Hasbro Pulse in this country. So I'm super excited to be able to play a bigger part in this year. And as Transformers fans, we have a lot to look forward to from the Transformers panel. They mention more figures to be revealed from Wave 3 of Kingdom. They're going to share some exciting news around the final chapter of Netflix Transformers trilogy. We are told we should look out for Commander and Titan class figures, including a first time character to appear in a toy. Arc confirmed, maybe. Or the Arc, I guess, has been used actually in Transformers Animated, am I wrong? So maybe this isn't the Arc, maybe this will be something else entirely. Very, very exciting. But if you read down the bottom, what's got me super excited is this piece here around Hasbro Pulse to reveal a toy capsule partner with IDW Publishing that will turn the Transformers universe upside down. Shattered Glass? Do we think that this will be Shattered Glass comics and toys coming out? Really deep diving into that after seeing the success of the Shattered Glass Prime and Ratchet that they had? Let me know your thoughts. That's my hopes and dreams. I'm actually pretty excited for this. It's been a while since we've had anything like this from Hasbro, so I will see you all there. If you're new around here, please think about giving me a like, a share, and a subscribe. We are super close to 2K. We will hit that very, very soon, but we can only do that with your support. And I'll see you down in the comments. All right, guys, in a bit. Peace.